Hey all, before the stories, I want to let you know you can find print versions of these stories, and all stories going forward, on the Killer Orange Cat subreddit. Also, my sister has set up a merchandise store for the channel, and the links to both of these are included in the description. Enjoy the video. Number 1. Crown. I doubt many people may even remember that this place even existed. But before the days of Barnes & Noble, the biggest bookstore chain in the country was Crown Books. They discounted every book, and that was the reason why they were able to become so big for so long. However, the company closed in 2001. I used to be a manager of a Crown bookstore. It really was the best job that I ever had. Sure, it didn't pay that great, but the work itself was very satisfying. I honestly looked forward to going into work every day. I worked with some really smart students, and it was a huge change from the previous fast food joints that I had been employed in. Anyway, when the store was in its final throes, there wasn't a lot of money to go around. So every manager worked a shift by themselves. I took a lot of the closing shifts because I was a night owl. I almost always let my employees go home early, and I would be by myself in the store for an hour or so, just finishing the work. These days, it seems that the bookstores have shelves that the people can see over. The Crown store I worked in was not like this. The shelves were all very high, and you literally couldn't tell if there was anyone in the store with you. On the night this happened, I had one of my employees go up and down the aisles and check the bathrooms to make sure that there was no one in the store. When he confirmed this, I let the employees out the door, then made sure the lobby lights were off. And I went back into the back room to do the final paperwork for the day. Although I liked being in the store by myself, I had to admit that it was a bit frightening at times. But the back room had one of those combination button locks on it, so I was always fine back there. I was doing my paperwork when I realized that there was a book that was special ordered that had been shelved. So I went out in the store in order to look for it. There were a few security lights in the store, but they didn't provide much light. I didn't turn any of the other lights on, because they weren't supposed to be on after the store closed. The book was a diet book. So I went over to the self-help section, which is where we kept books like that. I walked down the first aisle and turned the corner. Checking through the books, I noticed that it wasn't on the shelf. I turned the other corner, and then checked on that side to see if the book was misplaced by a shelf or two. I did end up finding it. I then walked up to the front of the store. I cannot convey how creepy this was, walking through the store. I don't believe in ghosts, but have often thought that if a ghost existed, a bookstore would be the right place for him or her to hang out. So, walking around in a dark store with limited view, everything about it freaked me out. Every little noise caught my attention. Walking around the book stacks, I was happy when I made it to the front registers. We kept all special orders right there. I pulled out a slip and began writing. I'm not sure why I did it, but I raised my head up and looked at the security monitor. There were 4 cameras in the store. My blood nearly froze in my veins when I saw that someone was in the self-help aisle that I had just recently walked out of. It was a big man, maybe over 6 foot tall, dressed in black and holding some sort of weapon in his hand. I wasn't sure what to do. I should have just left the store and went and called the police. I didn't want to do it in the store because if the guy heard me, he might come after me. but I was too stupid to consider doing that. Instead, I thought of the back room and the combination door. The self-help section was on the complete opposite side of the store, so I could probably get to the back room before he did. After standing for a moment, I jumped over the counter and began booking for the back room. It was down a short hallway. I got to the door with no problem. I typed in the 4-digit code and turned the handle. As I did so, I caught movement out of the corner of my eye and saw the man at the end of the short hallway. I swung the door open and ran in, forcing the door closed. I immediately saw the handle moving. He was trying to get in. When he realized he couldn't, he started pounding loudly on the door. I wasn't worried about the guy getting through the door. It was made to keep people out of the back room. I called the police, and they immediately sent a car over. When they arrived, the guy was just leaving the store through the front door, which he must have unlocked. They arrested him, and the item he was carrying was a very sharp knife. It took me a long time to be okay working alone again. Number 2. Borders. I used to work in a Borders bookstore. I was an assistant manager. One of my favorite people working at the store was a lady who was in charge of the children's section. She was a pleasant lady, and actually was very popular with everyone working there. The kids also liked her too. She did story time every week, and many, many kids came in to watch this woman with the amazingly friendly personality. One thing about the story time that no one really liked, though, were the costumes. We were sent costumes for certain stories, and were supposed to occasionally incorporate them into story time. No one liked to wear them because they always just seemed really dirty. We never had any real idea how old they were and how many people might have worn them before. So, finding anyone to play them was never that easy. The costumes would be shipped in huge boxes, and as a manager, I was one of the people who had to sign for them when they arrived. The day this weird stuff happened, I heard the back buzzer. Upon going back there, I brought the box in and curiously opened it. It was a really ugly and scary-looking thing. Is some sort of humanoid character with a really big head. I wish I could recall what children's book the character was from, but I can't bring it out of my memory. The thing was creepy, and although most workers didn't want to wear the costumes to begin with, they especially didn't want to wear this one. The normal people who could be convinced were adamant that this was not one they were willing to put on. Finally, when no one else would agree to it, to keep the story time happening, the story lady decided that she would wear the costume, if I was willing to read the story to the children. It wasn't something that I had ever done before, but I was definitely willing. About an hour before the story time, the story lady went into the back room to put on the costume. I went and grabbed a copy of the book. At the story time, when the children were all gathered around, the story lady didn't show up at first. And when she finally did, it was very odd. She was stumbling a little bit. I assumed it was just her acting like the character, whom I wasn't familiar with. I began reading the book, and the character was supposed to have kids sit on her lap. But she didn't sit down. Instead, she just tried waving to the kids and shaking hands. After a few moments, though, she almost fell over onto one of the kids. I was confused, but thought she may have just lost her balance in the costume. I had this horrible thought in my mind that she wasn't really in the costume. I thought maybe someone might have done something to her or something, but that didn't make sense. I didn't think anyone could have gotten into our stockroom. However, suddenly, the character fell down on his knees. I was concerned at first and went up to her. And then suddenly, I heard her throwing up inside the suit. The kids all got freaked out and moved away. I helped her get her costume head off. The lady looked horrible. She was sweaty and looked a strange shade of red. I thought that perhaps she was just suffocating in the suit. I tried to help her to the back room while calling another manager over to try and take care of the children. I managed to get her into the stock room. I moved her over to a chair, which just happened to be beside the box the costume came in. She looked just awful. I called an ambulance. Upon examining the costume, they found the tip of a razor in the costume, laced with poison. The lady recalled feeling a sharp pain when putting the costume on, but thought maybe it was just something in the costume that was broken. She didn't think it was anything to worry about. We had to get the police involved at that point. Knowing some sick individual must have put that razor in there. However, there really wasn't enough information to find out who. The story lady recovered, but we never got another person in the store to ever wear a costume again. Number 3. Barnes & Noble. Hey, Killer Orange Cat. I know that you don't generally put stories on your channel that have supernatural elements in them, but I hope you will narrate this story. It's a really freaky experience that I had while working at the Barnes & Noble in Crystal Lake, Illinois. I remember working at the information deck on this day. I received a phone call and answered it. The person claimed to be a person working for a local newspaper. I was later to find out that this was not true. It was, in actuality, a person who was working at the Borders bookstore in Gurnee, Illinois. I only found this out because one of my good friends worked at that store and told me about it. The guy from Borders asked me about the store being haunted. I told him I'd never heard of such a thing. He asked to speak to a manager. I was right beside the manager, who did tell him that the haunting was just a rumor, and there was no validity to it. After the phone call, I asked the manager what it was all about. She told me that the store had a reputation for being haunted. Employees who worked there before her reported it, and it was even written in a book. I guess around Halloween time, they always got calls from people asking about the haunting. It was simple things like book carts being moved without anyone around, books falling off the shelves when they had no reason to be doing that. And there were stories of physical entities as well. There was supposedly a blue ball of light, and an old man who looked like a farmer. However, all of the current employees at the store had never seen anything, so it was all considered to be made up. I'm not going to be one of those people who claim they didn't believe in ghosts before my experience. Honestly, whenever I hear someone claim that, I roll my eyes. I seriously doubt they were skeptical to begin with, and they just claim that in order to make their stories seem much more believable. I, in fact, did believe in ghosts, although I had never actually experienced a haunting before. I just felt that a world in which ghosts existed was a lot more interesting than one in which they didn't. It was about a week later when I was working on a closing shift. I had begun reorganizing our manga and graphic novel section, which had a tendency to get messed up. The managers always had to keep one employee in the store with them after closing. I wasn't done with my work, so I agreed to stay. It generally took the manager up to an hour and a half to finish working, and I intended to use that time to get all my work done. The store was always dark after closing. You know, you can't let people think the store was still open. And I have to admit, it was pretty creepy sitting in that big and dark store all alone. And the manager was back in the office, and the office door was locked because he was counting money. I finally finished the majority of my work. Then, I noticed that once I had everything shelved good, there was a large empty spot. I'd worked so hard on it at that point that I wanted to go and get some more books, so it would look perfect. There weren't any on the book carts, so I had to go into the back room. Our back room was huge, and it had tons of shelves. Now, the shelves didn't have backs on them, so you could see through to other parts of the stock room. Still, most of them were overstocked with books, so if someone had been in there, it would have been plausible for him to sneak up on you. However, I didn't really feel that anything like that was likely. It was just my own mind making up a fear. The lighting was also dim in there. I didn't really think about turning more lights on, though. I'd been back there plenty of times, and would only be there for a few minutes anyway. And it was creepy, though at the time, I really had forgotten about the whole haunted talk I had with the other manager. I went to the overstock shelf. They had the unshelved graphic novels on them. I pulled up a really small handcart, which was like a small dolly. I took some books and laid them down on the dolly. I think it was after I'd bent down about 2 times that when I stood back up, I looked through the shelves and came face to face with a man standing on the other side of the shelves. He was looking at me and looked very angry. I yelped and nearly fell backward, taking my eyes off him for a moment. When I looked back up, he was gone. I thought he had to be in the stockroom, possibly coming around the shelf for me. I left the graphic novels behind and ran for the stockroom door. I exited and ran to the office. I pounded on the door, and when the manager opened, I told him that someone was in the store, and he had to still be in the store because the alarms would be set off if he went through the door. We barricaded ourselves in the office and looked through all of the security cameras. The police came, and just like us, they didn't find anything. One of the policemen told us that he thought we were playing a prank, because he had been called out a few years before for a very similar story. They found no one, and the alarms never went off, so the person couldn't have left. And it was an angry man who was in the back room. We were freaked out. Most of the other employees didn't believe us, though. They thought I made it up because of receiving that phone call a week earlier. But no, that wasn't it. I really saw a man back there. Hey all, Killer Orange Cat here. I hope that you all had a very happy Halloween. You can read the print version of these stories on the Killer Orange Cat subreddit, and visit the Killer Orange Cat merchandise store at the links included in the description. I want to make sure everyone is updated about the Bloody Mary Challenge. I didn't forget about it, and I will be doing it. Just because of things going on in my personal life, I wasn't able to do it before Halloween. It will be coming, though. If you like this video, please let me know by hitting the like button. If you're not already subscribed to Killer Orange Cat, please consider hitting the subscribe button below, or use the icon of Ichigo that will appear at the end of this closing. Feel free to leave some comments to let me know what you think of the video, and consider sharing it with someone you think might enjoy it. You can always follow Ichigo and myself on Facebook and Twitter. If you have a story you'd like narrated on Killer Orange Cat, please email it to the address included in the description. My only requirement is that the story is original, meaning it has not been read on any other YouTube channel. And please, don't forget to make sure to check in your closet and check under your bed, because you never know where Killer Orange Cat might be hiding. Good night.